All right, man, we are recording. I am with KP, my brother from another mother. Always happy to have him on the podcast. We are going to play a mystery song. Well, we know what it is, but you guys don't know what it is yet. So we're going to do a reaction. It's not really, it's more of a reaction to just the song. There's not really a video for it, but everyone knows what song this is. Right?
Yes.
All right, hold on. Here we go.
Oh no! Oh boy! Ah, here it comes! The motherfucking loud spot!
All right, I do want to remind everybody that if you do like our videos, even if you don't like it, subscribe, like, dislike, comment. I don't care. Do it. It helps the show out. This is just on YouTube. Not an actual podcast. So, KP, man, what is up?
What's going down?
You're wearing a sweater, bro. Isn't it warm over there where you're at?
Yeah, but I'm just wearing it because I'm outside right now. So,
dude, before we even do the song, I do want to talk about what we talked about last night. Nikki Glaser.
She's okay. My favorite female stand-up.
And I did not think her stand-up was that good.
Well, listen, I was hanging out with her today, and I learned something new. So what?
Not really hanging out.
No, but she actually was like talking to people on her live stream, and I commented a bunch of stuff, and she was responding. So we were hanging out. But what I learned is not only is she like super funny, but she also plays guitar and sings really good.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I don't really pay attention to her career, I guess, but her stand-up.
You just don't have a sense of humor. Dude,
I do have a sense of humor. I just personally did not like it. It wasn't horrible. Not saying
so
it was
for
horrible.
All the viewers, go to Netflix, pull up Nikki Glaser. Looks like Nikki Glaser. Nikki Glaser. The name of the stand-up is called Bangin'.
She has and a podcast too. That's actually pretty good. It's pretty popular, I guess.
And after you guys watch it, you guys will see what an old man Sebastian is because he didn't think it was funny and it was hilarious.
No, I did not say I didn't think it was funny. I said...
That's what you said to me, dude.
No, okay.
I didn't think it was funny.
It was funny. It just wasn't like the best.
You said it's not my style.
I felt like... I don't know. I thought that
you were watching
like
it at
someone
work.
Seeking help or something. I don't know. It seemed like,
oh my gosh,
that's what it seemed desperate or something to me. Okay. I'm not saying she's not funny. She is funny.
Sebastian wants to be a therapist.
No. Comedy is subjective. That's all I'm saying. And that's not really my type of comedy, but what's her comedy special called?
It's called Bangin'.
And it was banging a bunch of dudes.
No.
Yeah. Well, apparently she is. According to I watched like I was watching it, and I wasn't able to pay as much attention to it as I probably could have. So I am going
to
rewatch
it.
I'm going to rewatch it with no distractions, and maybe I'll find it more funny.
I don't know. You're going to find it hilarious, dude. It's hilarious.
I don't know. What's the other show you told me to watch on Netflix?
Oh, All American.
I haven't seen that yet. What's that about?
It's based on a true story. There's like the it's kind of I don't want to tell you. Watch it.
You told me to watch it. And then maybe we'll talk about it. I don't know. You know, I love doing these live reaction videos, but you know, maybe we'll do a little bit of talking about other things before we go right into the video. I think it's kind of fun. I always love when you're on, man. You're one of my best friends. Known you for dude, like almost 20 years now, man.
Or more.
No, because I met you when I was 21.
Sebastian still counts on his fingers. Don't believe him, dude. It's more than 20.
21, 20 years. But 2-0.
The only education Sebastian got was in his alphabet soup.
I did eat
1, 2, 3.
I don't know if I ate much alphabet soup as a kid. I think I ate a little bit of it, a little bit.
Dude, alphabet soup tasted better back in the day than it does
dude,
now.
No. You know what?
It's tasted watery now or something.
No, you know what? Chicken noodle soup. You know, when I was a kid, I thought that was healthy for you, like chicken noodle soup. Like when you're sick, right? So when you're sick, you think that these soups your parents give you are like healthy for you. There's so much freaking sodium in those soups. They're not healthy for you. I hate to break it to everyone, but they're just not.
No. Here,
but when you're a kid,
you're sicker than a dog. Let's just fill you up with salt.
Salt cures everything. Just eat some ramen noodles. Same thing. But chicken noodle soup is good, whether it's alphabet, stars. The stars are always
homemade fun. Chicken noodle soup is good.
Dude, my wife, Stacia, dude, she makes the best homemade chicken noodle soup. She can cook.
You hear that, Stacia? He's over here trying to get points with you. Don't accept
it. We don't need a reaction video, dude. We could just talk like this all day.
I know. Seriously.
We do this all the time anyways on FaceTime. We should just do it on record and then just put it on as a fucking YouTube show.
Yeah, no, we could go do TikTok, YouTube,
whatever we want.
Screw a podcast. We'll call it a conversation cast.
A convo we'll just cast. Sit and talk. Convo cast, dude.
Convo cast, dude.
That's the new thing.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll just
do people
sit and
even
talk.
Listen to podcasts anymore?
People don't even talk no more. They text.
Gosh. Fucking hate text messages, dude.
Dude,
I hate text messages so much. That's what my pet peeve is. Like, I hate group text. I hate group text messages. I opt out of them
because my phone sits and goes bling, 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 bling. Yeah.
It's like eight people. Everyone is like, dude, I don't care about your conversation. Like, leave me alone. I do not. Yeah, I don't opt out, but I silence them, and then I'll go back and look.
Everybody wants to hear a conversation. That's why people be like, when you're out and someone's having a conversation, I don't care who you are. And if you say you don't, you're lying. You're kind of low key. Like, what are they talking about? You know,
dude. So because my mom, and you know this, and I've talked about it before, my mom can't hear, you know, she's deaf. And I always,
no, she can hear me.
I always wonder she's like ever like reads
out like talk
lips
to you.
and like eavesdrops on their conversations, and it's like, oh, what's going on? Because she's so good at reading lips, you know.
Bro, your mom has the whole family fooled because she can hear me. I've had full conversations with her. She's got you guys fooled. She doesn't want to talk to you guys.
She's like, dude, when I was a kid, I used to think she was faking it actually. I remember going up to her and screaming in her ear to see if she could never hear me. I'm not sure she'd have a hearing aid on, though.
No.
If she did, I'd be screaming in her ear, and she would just be doing the dishes. I'm like, rah! And she'd be like, I'm like, oh.
That's jacked up, bro, because
I'm telling you. I wasn't jacked up. She can't hear. As a kid, I'm curious. I want to make sure she ain't lying on me, dude.
Now he's looking for a sympathy card. Look. She can hear, and you probably busted her eardrum out screaming like that.
Well,
he goes,
if
up
she wasn't deaf, she is now
like a Treyu.
Oh, dude. Well, I used to love like trying to play tricks, and I was so mean sometimes when I was a little kid, trying to play tricks, trying to take advantage of the fact. But you know when you're a kid, you do shit like that, man. As an adult, I don't do it at all anymore.
So wrong, dude.
I know. I'm such a bad person.
Horrible.
All right. Let's get on to this mystery song. Everybody is going. Well, I don't think everybody knows this song.
Dude,
but
kids these days, bro, I was talking to some, younger. They were working with me, and there were artists that I was mentioning that they never heard of before.
Weird. Well,
and I was
like who?
Like artists that you should know. Like Coolio, like
Tupac.
Like, well, everybody knows Tupac. If someone says,
I don't know
Tupac,
that, dude. Don't know some of these younger kids, bro. I don't know, man. Do some of the bands I've interviewed, like, I'm surprised when people don't know who, like, Bowling for Soup is, or they don't know who, like,
wait, who? What did you just say?
Bowling for Soup.
Bowling for Soup.
You know who that is?
I don't know who that is, bro.
Dude, are you kidding me?
No, Bowling for Soup.
Oh my God.
Don't don't act that way, bro, because I asked you who the singer was for
You don't know who Bowling for Soup is, bro?
Bro. Do you remember who I asked you?
They got that song U2 and Blondie, or has it way before there was U2 and Blondie and music still on MTV.
The what?
1989? 1980. Pop punk. It's a pop punk band. They got another song. You know, hold on. Let me tell you what the other song is.
Who's the singer for Black Sabbath?
Fuck you, bro.
Seriously?
Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah, you only know that because I told you after you didn't
know. No, I did know that. I did.
I will pull up the podcast that it was on.
But you caught me off guard.
No.
Yes.
No, because you gave me an answer. I think you said like Axl Rose or something.
No, I might have. Let me go. Songs. Born for
Sugar.
The girl all the bad guys want. The girl all the bad guy. You know what though? You're a little bit older, and that song came out probably when you were more into like Cottonmouth Kings.
No, I'm like more 90s grunge era, Alice in Chains.
Yeah, Soundgarden, that wasn't Bowling for Soup was kind of like late 90s, early 2000s pop punk.
Yeah.
Okay, so another band I interviewed, I don't know, I guess everyone knows who Hinder is still, I guess. But yeah, I'm surprised you didn't know who that was. That's funny. Not that Bowling it's funny. What?
Yeah, I thought you were joking. I was like,
they bowl for Alphabet Soup.
I thought you were going to say like Bone Thugs and Harmony or something. Bowling
some people don't know who Ace of Base is.
Because they didn't see the sign. They missed it.
Well, I saw the sign and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. I also know who Jamiroquai is. That motherfucker's badass.
Oh, yeah. Jamiroquai. He's dope.
Yeah. I talked about him on a podcast one time. All right. Let's play this song. And you know what? I was trying to listen to some of the lyrics of it. And I want you, if I can't hear what they're saying, I want you to tell me what it is. Not, I don't know if you know all the lyrics or not. We're going to listen to it and see what people think of this mystery song. Everybody, I don't care what age you are, whether you're 90 or you're, I'm not going to say 9, but at least like 20. If you like music at all, I don't care what genre. I don't care if you like rock, punk rock, heavy metal, hip hop, R&B, country, jazz, blues, polka, whatever. You need to know this song. This is a
classic. Of us might be alive because of this song. Some of us might even be alive because of it.
This was a baby maker.
Yeah. This is like lots of baby making. Like by a long shot.
I'm surprised Nikki Glaser didn't talk about it on her podcast.
Bro. She did, but you didn't watch it. That's why you don't think it's funny.
I didn't watch it. Okay. All right. Here we go. I gotta do one of these real quick. Let me see if I can play it. No, I gotta do one of these. Here we go. There we go. And here's the song. And we're gonna go back to this. Boom. Let's listen. Who doesn't know who Marvin Gaye is, bro?
Wow. You know when he says, I've been trying to hold back this feeling for so long. I wonder what it was that he was feeling. I don't think I know. He's dead.
He passed away?
Dude, his dad killed him.
What?
I swear to God.
It's not funny.
Dude, shot.
I thought he was still alive.
Oh yeah,
he died in 1984.
I don't know. His dad shot him.
That's so fucked up.
It's so not funny.
Let me see how he died. Death. Oh, we're going to hell, dude. Oh, yeah. Gaye intervened in a fight between his parents on the afternoon of April 1st in the family house in the West Adams district of Los Angeles. Yeah, it was shot. Marvin Gaye Sr., who shot him twice in the chest. Damn, dude, that's one way to go out.
Damn.
Well, I didn't know that. I didn't know that, dude. That's why it's funny.
I think it was just like the way I said
it. I laugh when I'm nervous. Okay. Well, that just kind of took away the whole atmosphere we were trying to create.
Well, first we're talking about making babies. Oh my god.
Oh my god, dude.
He got shot by his dad.
Well, don't shoot your kids, people. Do not do that. Especially if they're Marvin Gaye, all right? He's fucking classic. All right, here we go. I'm surprised you know so much about so many different... You always surprise me about how much you know about different things, dude. All right, here we go.
Let's get it on. Understand each other since we got to be here.
You think he wrote his own music?
Dude, I think his dad shot him because he was too sensitive. He's like, we're all sensitive people. His dad was mad.
So he's like,
wait, what did you ask?
I said, do you think he writes his own music?
Heck yeah.
Because you know, a lot of the artists back in the day didn't write their own. Like Babyface wrote a lot of people's songs, including, I think, Michael Jackson's music.
Google
Don't
it.
Quote me on that, but I think.
Google it. Did Marvin Gaye write his own music?
I will.
I think he did.
I'll Google it right now. Dude, I got to blow my nose now. Dude, Marvin Gaye write his own music. One of the most important artists to come out of Motown, Marvin Gaye wrote songs for other artists, including Beachwood and the Marvelettes. Ooh. Dude, Marvin Gaye wrote songs for the Marvelettes. It's weird.
Yeah. And Beachwood.
So this cuts down his composing, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I think he wrote his own song. I mean, if he wrote other people's songs, he probably wrote his own songs.
Yeah.
I would assume. So I still got tears in my eyes, man. Oh, my God.
I do, too.
I needed that laugh, bro. That was funny. It wasn't. It's not funny, but it's funny.
It's not funny.
But the way you said it, that made me laugh. Okay. All right. Here we go.
Wait till you watch Nikki Glaser.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Nikki Glaser's comedy is definitely better than what we just did. That I laughed
yes.
at. All right, here we go.
Let's live. I love you.
My favorite part of the song's coming up, but you know what I want to say is, what if someone's like trying to make a baby right now to this show on YouTube, but we keep on pausing it to talk, and they're like, "Fuck, man, I'm just trying to get off, bro."
Right. And they're
like, "Quit talking, motherfuckers." Let's play a song. All right, here we go. Here's for your baby making needs, baby.
How sweet and wonderful life is. Asking you, baby, to give
the push of the bed.
What a fucking good voice, man. I like when he says, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's fucking brilliant, dude. Like, I love that part specifically is my favorite part of the song.
What year did this song come out?
I'll tell you.
Was it like 74
what year
or
did
something?
Marvin Gaye, Let's Get It On come out?
Probably like 74.
Let's Get It On. It came out in... you know, let me, my phone's being weird. Let me, 1973.
Ooh, I was a year off.
Well, that's when the deluxe edition came out. So it probably came out before that.
Isn't it crazy how, the term beating around the bush has like taken on a whole new thing now than then?
Yeah. What year did,
like, I wonder what he was talking about. Was he talking about, like, being straight up, or was he talking about, like, beating around the bush?
I don't know. I don't know. Let me see. Let me see what this says. Yeah, I'm trying. 1973. So that's when it was released. So I didn't really hear your question because I was looking at my phone. All right, here we go.
You can't do two things at the same time.
No, it's hard. It's hard.
No,
it's
I know.
Hard.
I know.
It's so hard. You've known me for like almost 20 years, bro. You know how I know.
It's going to be okay.
I think I'm getting worse as I get older.
You are.
I used to pride myself in being like a multitasker. Now I'm like a one tasker.
Yeah.
One task. I'll do it. Move on to the next one. All right. Here we go. Let's make some more babies, y'all. I didn't realize he was part of the Motown era, dude. Era.
Look, so the youngsters that we were just talking about, you're one of them.
Okay. But I still know the song. I still know who he is. Huh?
You what?
Well, you know, Motown to me is like Smokey Robinson, right?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
So, Marvin Gaye to me doesn't really. And mentally, anyways, you know, I grew up in a different time, you know, obviously, but I didn't consider mentally, him more of a Motown.
I told you,
to me was
Sebastian
like more
wants
like
to be a therapist.
Motown to me was like the 60s.
Dude, Marvin Gaye. When I think of Marvin Gaye, I think Motown.
You do?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't. Yeah. I didn't. I could see that. It just I didn't think. So, but it does make sense. I love you, dude.
Here we go. Love you too. Super classic track.
You don't have Is a classic that will always be a classic. It'll be around 100, 200, and 500 years from now, man.
There yeah, that track has stood the test of time. It's not going nowhere.
Nope. It will always stand the test of time, dude. I'm still smiling about the whole thing earlier, dude.
I know.
I saw you smiling too, man. So, anyways, that was our mystery track. You know, we should do mystery tracks every now and again. That's kind of a cool concept, bro.
Yeah, no, it is.
A little bit of talking first, a little bit of reaction video. Not really a reaction video, more to the song and just kind of paying tribute to the song, I guess. In our 2022. Own way.
So now we're gonna do something new. We'll do these. Ooh. Let's do these.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea, man. I think it's a good idea.
Convo cast.
What? Vote no. What? Hold on. What did we call it earlier?
Convocast.
Convocast. Yeah. Vocast. Did you say vocast earlier?
Convocast like with the music track.
Just a vote, dude. But you can instead of conversation or convo, just vote. Vocast.
Vote. Yeah. We'll just
fuck your
it,
podcast. This is a vocast. Actually, this is really not even. This isn't really a podcast. This is a vlog. We're calling it a vocast, though.
This isn't a blog, bro.
Vlog. I didn't say blog. I said vlog. V as in Victor. V-L-O-G. Vlog, a video.
Blog, ooh, I don't need you to spell it.
A video. It's called a vlog, anyways. It stands for video.
He's all vlog.
Vlog. Like, it's a vlogging
as
Molly.
As in Victor.
A flogging Molly poster. Oh, I have one. I got Dropkick Murphys. All right, man. That's all I got. Do you want to say anything else, man?
No. I had fun. This was good.
All right. If anybody else wants to watch more of our reaction videos or just the podcasting, we're on Apple, we're on Spotify. As far as the podcasting, we do a lot of interviews. This, we do reaction videos for YouTube. They're always very fun to do, especially when KP's on. We always have a blast. Check us out on every platform, and go to patreon.com/theloudspot. $3 a month really does help us out. And our website is www.theloudspot.net. I guess that is all. So we got, and subscribe.
Oh, and pineapple belongs on pizza. I don't know who needed to hear that, but.
And if you disagree.
We'll talk about it next time.
You know, we should do a whole video on pineapple on pizza.
We're going to.
We'll do it next time.
Yeah.
We're going to catch some hate for that. We're going to catch hate on a lot of this. All right. Peace out, rock on, and much love.
This is the Loud Spot outro by Nothing Short of Tragic.
Is this all talk with no action? No. Is this my thoughts with distraction? No. Is this what I bought that's in fashion? Or is this the Loud Spot with Sebastian? Yes. Does Nothing Short of Tragic have his back again? Yes. Does everything that's good really have to end? Yes. Our pin post has a pin show, so to get more episodes, make an order, this is over.
Thanks for watching our video. Don't forget to click the like and share button.
Don't forget to go to our YouTube and subscribe.
If you want to listen to our audio and pick up some cool merch, go to www.theloudspot.net. Peace out, rock on, much love.